Good morning, students. In the previous session, we read about food and its sources. That is chapter number 1 of your textbook. Today we will take this next topic, that is food habits of animals. On the basis of feeding habits or food habits, animals are categorized into 6 different parts. Herbivores. Herbivores are animals that eat only plants. Example, cow, deer and buffalo. In the second category, carnivores, flesh-eating animals. Tiger, lion and eagle are such examples that eat only flesh. Not only animals, birds are also carnivores in nature. Omnivores, both plant and flesh-eating animals are called omnivores. Example, human being, raccoon and bears. Fourth category, scavengers. Scavengers feed on dead animals and plants. Jackal and hyena are examples of scavengers. Similar to scavengers are the decomposers, but these decomposers break down. They do not feed, they break down. They do not eat. They just break remain of dead plants and animal and decompose. They help nature or our environment. Similar to scavengers. Scavengers also help our environment. They keep environment clean. Decomposers also help to keep environment clean. Parasites are the last one. They live on or inside the bodies of other organisms. Example, tapeworm, hookworm and lice. Next topic is food chain. As you know that each and every living organism depend on each other for their feeding habits. Food chain is a sequence which represent that how animal is dependent. It tells us that who eats whom. Its definition is like this: a food chain represents the food dependence of living organism in a natural environment. It tells us who eats whom. It is represented by arrow. As you can see here, arrows are indicating that which animal is eaten by whom. For example, grass is eaten by deer and deer is eaten by lion. The organism at the first level, here, grass, which is generally a producer. Animal which eat grass, we had already read, they are called herbivores. So the next sequence is of herbivores and they are called primary consumers, which is followed by secondary consumer. Secondary consumer always feed on herbivores. They eat herbivores. So they are obviously carnivores. So they are tertiary consumer. They are secondary consumers are followed by tertiary consumer. Tertiary consumers are also maybe carnivores or they may be fungi, scavengers, parasites. On the basis of this representation, grass, which is a producer, it produces food and it is eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper, which is further eaten by frog. Frog is in the category of secondary consumer as it consumes grasshopper which feed on grass. Frog is eaten by snake. Snake is eaten by eagle. Eagle is a final consumer. It is when it dies, it is decomposed by fungi. Here are the other examples which you can see that food chains are interlinked together. They are food webs. So students, this is in students, you have to do homework and you have to learn glossary of chapter number 1, herbivores, consumers, decomposers and carnivores. They are given in your book. Read and learn from it. Thank you.